I wanted to make a video for you to show you how to package large paintings for shipping. Here are the supplies that you will need. I got a U-Haul box, see? Large mirror box. That's what you need for the big paintings. They have one that's a little bit smaller than this, but it wasn't big enough for what I needed. Then you need some peanuts, you know, the styrofoam things, maybe some old tissue papers. I also like to shred old papers and things like that, and it makes great packing material. You also need one of these, some type of cutting instrument, and then you need your tape dispenser, and you want to get some shipping tape that's a lot sturdier for shipping purposes. Now the painting that we're going to be packaging today is this one. See, it fits that box right there. Gives me a little bit of room for cushion around it. So these are the large plastic bags. I got rolls and rolls of them. When I was doing the shows, I needed to have a lot of plastic bags. They're the, I think they're like 40 or 50 gallon plastic bags. I mean, they're big. And some people are going to tell you not to put plastic up against your painting, because it could damage it in shipping or something like that. And so, you know, I've never had it happen. I used to put tissue paper over all of this, and I've never had a problem. Probably two bags, I'm guessing, to cover the whole painting. This is another reason why canvas is better than the paper, large paper with the matting and framing. You can't lift it around like that. Plus, it costs a lot more to ship. These boxes, when you buy them like this, are very expensive. I think this one cost around $7. The smaller mirror box, just a little bit smaller than this, is $5.50. Now, if you ship a lot of large paintings, you're better off purchasing them from Uline. Uline can give you some package deals when you buy in larger quantities now, and save yourself a lot of money that way. But see, I don't ship as many large paintings now as I used to. So this is why I've switched over to buying the individual boxes. Wanted to show you the Uline catalog that has all the shipping things that you could ever want. And they ship very quickly. Now, I drop in either my shredded paper, tissue paper, peanuts, what have you, to make a cushion at the bottom. Can't make it too thick, obviously, because then your painting won't fit. So I fastened the two bags together, and I just slide my painting down. The other thing that you have to do is allow yourself some room on the top, because you want to put your padding around here. You also need to put padding down on the ends. This then is the top of the box. Almost ready to tape up. It's pretty solid. You don't want it floating around in there. On the outside of the box, you can see it says Picture Packer. There's a separate little kit that you can get. It contains these corners that you can put on your paintings. to keep them from moving around in case you have the glass. Okay, so I'm getting ready to take my package over to FedEx. I put my label on there and covered it over with packaging tape to prevent it from smearing. You don't even need to put a label on it if you're going to FedEx because you have to fill out one of their labels anyhow. But I do this as double protection. I use FedEx. I found their prices to be very comparable. The post office will not ship packages this large. You also can use UPS or DHL. But I found that for me, FedEx is the best. You can set up an account with FedEx online. And if you're doing shipping of large packages on a regular basis, you can arrange it so that they will come to the house and pick up your shipments, like on a weekly basis or something like that, or bi-weekly. But I just wanted to let you know that that's everything that I know about shipping large packages.